Guys, welcome to Excel tutorial channel again. Now we have covered all the count and sum functions previously in our previous playlist. If you haven't watched that, please do that. And from now on we will be doing and covering all logical function in Excel, where we covered from the basic to advanced. So in this video we will talk about the main logical functions, which are if, and, or not. So we will cover these four logical functions in this chapter, and you will learn a lot about the basic functionality of these, and we will discuss the advanced functionality of these in the upcoming videos, so you can have the better understanding of these functions. So please keep watching this video because you're gonna learn so much in this video. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do it, because in the past, as you have seen, we have covered all the functions and we will cover all the functions in the upcoming months, days, or weeks. So let's get started. So here we have this very basic worksheet here, practice worksheet. If you want to download this worksheet, you can download by clicking the link below in the description box, because you can, you know, participate or you can practice with these such data, which is very basic. But if you are learning this piece of software which can help in your career, then you can also do that the same. So here we have the name. Okay, name here, the first name, all like 27 students name, and we have a class like 10th, and we have maths, English, and science. So what are the if, or you can say what are the logical functions? Logical function, there should be a logic behind it. For example, if you want to find out if people are failed in maths or not, so basic maths criteria, what will be the basic pass and fail criteria? There should be a minimum number to score to pass, right? To score the minimum number of scores in particular subject, so you need a logical explanation in your answer. So how are you gonna do that? So let's say we take minimum score to pass is 40, so this is the 40% of the 100. Okay, let's find out if Joseph or all the other member or student in the class have passed or not in maths. So you can do that easily with the if function. If you have watched the if function in the Hindi part, you can skip this video, and if you are watching this the first time, then you can please carry on. So here what we're gonna do is we're gonna find if the students are passed in maths or not. So let's say maths result, just using the abbreviation, don't want to take more space. So here we will put or enter if function here. So logical test, what will be the logical test? So logical test will be this, which is the maths marks of Joseph greater than equal to 40. So there will be two arguments here. First argument, we have filled the logical test. So second will be the value if true or value if false. So value if true, what will be the value if true? If C2, which is the marks of Joseph in maths, is greater than equal to 40, what will be the value? Value will be pass, right? And if value if false, then you can simply say fail. It's as simple as that, right? Then we close the parentheses here, and here we enter. So Joseph is passed. Congratulations, Joseph. And if we drag down to the all participants in this class, then we have found some are failed and some are passed. This way you can function your if function basically with the help of. So in this way you can find pass or fail candidates with the help of if function. So it's as easy as that. Okay, so next will be the and function. I know this is very basic, so whatever telling you here is very basics, but we will cover each and every function in detail in the upcoming videos. So I am just giving the overview of all the logical function, basic logical function in Excel. So next, what we're gonna do is, so next function is and function returns true if all conditions are true, and returns false if any of the conditions are false. So this is the and function. This is also a logical function. When all conditions are true, then it will give you true. If any one conditions you have met enter in the and function, then it will be false. So how are we gonna do that? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna enter three criteria here. Like we want to see, or we want to know if all the students' marks are greater than 40 or not in each subject. So this will be a total result, right? So if any student failed in either in English or science, then they are termed as failed. They cannot pass on to the next class. So how are we gonna do that? We're gonna do that with the help of AND function. So how are we gonna do that? Just click enter here and open these logical arguments. So this is the very plain and simple function where you can enter any logic here based on your number, dates, strings, text, etc. So first logical will be our this greater than equal to 40, this greater than equal to 40, and again this greater than equal to 40, and close the parentheses and click enter. So here is false. Why? Because he is failed in English, so he cannot pass on to the next language. If he cannot pass the English language, then he need to do the class 10th again. And if we find apply to all here, drag it down, so many students are failed and many students are balls also, so many are failure. So it's just example. This way you can do that with the multiple logical criteria. You can perform AND function here. So what we got is Joseph is failed because he was failed in English, so he doesn't qualify to the next class. So next will be OR function. What does the OR function means? OR function returns true if any of the conditions are true. Like if I want to find out, like here, let me enter the total here, and what will be total plus this plus this. So let me okay, so next is with the OR function, what we're gonna find is there is a new criteria to select a student. Okay, so let's say, just for the demonstration, for the, you know, workaround of this function, either a student should score 40% of all subject, like 300 divided by 40 into 40% is equal to 120 marks, or should have passed in maths test. Okay, so either way, let's see if we can achieve that. So how are we gonna do that? First we're gonna enter OR function. So basically OR function returns true if any of the conditions are true, and returns false if any conditions are false. Okay, if one conditions of the logical in n number of logical, suppose you type 10 logical logical operator here, logical criterias here, okay, and if any one of them returns true, then your answer of all OR formula will be true. Hope you get that, and the difference between AND and OR. So what we're gonna do here is, in the first logic, what we're gonna do, we're gonna select this should be equal to 40, right? And in the second logical test, we should select the total should be equal to 120. Let's see if this fulfills or not, and close the parentheses and click enter. So it's true for the Joseph. Okay, he may didn't pass the English test, but he's passed the new criteria which is mentioned here. So if I apply to all here, so few students have failed in it, like this. So he didn't pass in maths with the 30 marks, also didn't score the minimum of 120 marks. So here you got the idea of how OR function performs, right? So here I give you the header criteria result. So we have covered if function here with the basic functionality of if, and now we have completed the OR, and next is the NOT. I have completed the NOT in the Hindi language. If you are familiar with the Hindi language, then do search that video in my channel, because I have covered that in detail. So what is NOT function? NOT is very simple. Like, NOT function changes true to false and false to true. If the value is false here, right, then it will be converted to true. For example, let's take this as a criteria. Suppose your head teacher says, we don't need this criteria, we need the opposite of this criteria. Like, we don't want that either C2 is greater than 40 or F2 greater than 120. So we just need the opposite of it. So how are we gonna do that? We simply apply NOT here and close the parenthesis. There you go. You get all the values as a false and which are true, it will be the false, and which are false, it will be true. Or for the basic example, let me take you this not. So we will do the total results as a not. We will take this, okay? The total number of all the subjects should not be less than 120. If I say this, it says true. It's not less than 120. If I this false rahe, if I apply to all, so see this, we got the 115 true. So we can also give it a header if this particular student has passed in the total number or not. So hope you get the point how to perform these logical functions in your daily work life. So we have covered the if function, or function, and not function here. If you have learned a little bit about these functions, then please click the like button. If you have some questions in mind, please do comment box below. If you want to learn these functions in depth, then do subscribe to our channel, because we're gonna cover it in the upcoming days. So see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.